And as Commander-in-Chief, I have determined that it is in our vital national interest to send an additional 30,000 U.S. troops to Afghanistan.
We as powerlifters are warriors, using every training session to build up to the inevitable battle on the platform. It's good to give back to the other group of warriors who are thousands of miles away from their home, fighting a different battle, fighting a different war, to allow us to continue to fight ours here. This powerlifting competition is not only about us, it's about all those who risk their life day in and day out and sacrifice their mind, bodies, and souls for their country. Members of the Wounded Warrior Project, this is for you.
My name is Corporal William Sutton, United States Marine Corps. Back in September 2010, my unit, 3rd Battalion, 5th Marines, deployed to Sangin, Afghanistan in Operation Enduring Freedom. On November 24th, 2010, we were out on patrol, doing a security patrol. We set up a support by fire position in order to cover the rest of the Marines that are trying to talk to the locals, get some intel, just meet and greet. During that time, I was tasked with the duty of setting up the support by fire. Once I set it up, I put myself in the area where I could best control the line. And as soon as I got down to just watch for enemy or if anything happened to my fellow Marines, we took contact.
And where the f*** did we get in contact from?
That hole we blew,
It was a big firefight about a company size of insurgents. My gunner at the time took a round off of the feed tray of the M240 Bravo machine gun. He passed out and I had to take the gun. Fired into the insurgents in the area that they were shooting from. I took one round to the arm. After that, I applied a tourniquet. I just kept firing. I kept firing and I took two more shots to the groin. One that went through my left testicle. Kept firing. After that, I started bleeding out very bad. I hit a major artery in my arm, it was bleeding out. I wasn't able to put the tourniquet on tight enough, and I passed out. At that point in time, a couple of other Marines ran over, putting themselves in harm's way to come get me. When that happened, I took a round to the back. Luckily, because of our savvy plates, it only temporarily paralyzed for a little while. But I managed to recover from it all. We got air on the station, just doing their thing, trying to protect us, and a medevac came down. I passed out on the way onto the bird, and when that happened, the last thing I remember hearing is machine gun fire. And that was my hope that my boys, I knew, were safe. As soon as I heard the more machine guns firing, the more safe I knew my boys would be. I got to the hospital, and I woke up 2 days later, and I saw my arm. They told me I had lost my left testicle, no hopes of having children. It got pretty emotional. I flew back to the States, and Wounded Warriors came and talked to me. They spent all their time just to protect us, make sure we're good mentally and physically, make sure we kept all of our appointments to get us better. Did physical therapy, and I was at Wounded Warriors for about 10, 11 months. Once I finally was able enough to go back to my unit, Wounded Warriors still kept track of me. They still kept asking me how I was doing, still asking for events, me to go to, everything that possibly they could do, they were there for me. My friends came, they all visited me. One of the members from the powerlifting team came, spent time with me, welcomed me into his home, and was just there as a friend and a fellow brother. Once once that was there, all it was hope. Just to have people there for you, to be there no matter what, thick or thin, no matter what you're going through with either PTSD, physical pains, emotional pains, just have somebody there is the best experience I could have ever had being wounded. I'm extremely grateful for the USPA out of Washington to help out with this event, for the extra funding, to help out myself and the fellow wounded warriors. It helps them out physically and mentally to know that there's somebody there that's gonna be there for them no matter what, through the tough times of transitioning from combat back to the way they need to be in order to survive against the civilian world. Even though combat on Afghanistan's front lines, or combat to yourself on the platform, you might have its differences, there are a lot of similarities. The art of combat, the desire to win mentally and physically. The desire on the platform is also to win mentally and physically. So no matter what we go through, we all have our wars. With the platform or with the enemy. But there's one outcome, to win.
Thank you.